I forgot to turn on the music. Oh, my CSP isn't open either. I forgot to do that. Hi, Anda. How are you? Oh, let me open up stuff. I forgot. Ah, don't look at that. No, it's fine, actually. It's just my OBS. Here. Ah, it's very quiet today because Haru's not here. Yeah. Oh, let me get my VGM com open. Copy. Up, up, up. Oh, let me mark as work in progress. I'm gonna work on it today. Oh, Ed. Oh, shoot, I know why. Sorry, I was messing around with reverb earlier. Files. Yes. Can I drop this in here? Alright. Oh, I don't think I really need this, like, extra blank space. Hold on. I really only need this part. There you go. Okay. Save that. Okay. It just feels like I shouldn't even be late. It's like, feel like it's too early because it's so quiet. You know? Cause it's just me today in the house. And tomorrow too. But just very quiet. I am gonna start with some like the sketches of something else. So party? No. I don't really think I know anybody that's close enough to even do that. Nope. Thank you. I will in a sec. Let me like... I'm thinking pose. But also, Pale, I hope you're doing well as well. Yep, staying hydrated. Yep. My tea is just too hot. I want to drink more of the tea, but like, I can't. But it's still too hot, I just got it. I see. No, I think you're stopping by. I am like struggling with this pose. I don't know what to do with her legs, is the problem. That's the problem, I don't know what to do with her legs. Oh yeah, that was all really cool. Thank you for sharing, Enda. I like these legs. I might try to figure out what to do with her legs. I mean, you could hold on. I'm like adjusting. That's why I'm out of frame. You could also use VGen now. If that is an option that's easier for you. I don't like these legs either. Legs go out like that, like kind of splayed a bit. Okay, yeah, I think it's technically fine that I have the... Yeah, it's whatever is easier for the commissioner. There's a little fuzzy on my tablet. I'm just struggling with this. Oh. Like finding a way to pose this. This part back, this part back. That. Not this. That. Mm-hmm. Huh? Oh, it cut off. Yeah, it really depends on what you get to with Mentor, you know? Sometimes you get a nice roulette, sometimes you don't, you know? I think it sort of works. I feel like at least when I get Rathalos, it's not too bad, but that could just be my experience with it. It's only a problem if, like, people don't heal, you know? People don't use the action. Which I usually get, oh, at most, like, it usually takes, like, what, like, two? Two attempts? Whenever I get it, so I don't know. Maybe I'm just lucky, you know? Maybe I don't like the hand. Oh. Well, see, I mean, that's literally just tell. I honestly, I kind of like having that because to me, it's like, well, if they can't just not die, like, I don't want to play with them anyway. Man, why does it not scroll all the way down? This is so annoying. Like, I don't know why, but sometimes my Twitch chat, like, overlay thingy doesn't scroll all the way down. And, like, I have to... I don't see... I see, like, only, like, half the fucking message. It drives me insane. I'm worried about the arms looking funny, like when... See, they just don't say anything, in my experience. Just nothing gets said. No, I don't like this arm either. See, I also have more people in Mentor Roulette refuse to pull more than single pulls, so... They just do single pulls and you're just like, well, okay. It sounds like you have a very different, experience with Mentor. In my case, like, it's more likely that they, single pull. I don't think I can do this pose like I wanted to. I think I'll still keep her face, but... people like that in any DC. I think people that just ignore, but I think the question is just whether or not, like... Like... Yeah, like, which one is more common, you know? I know, her thumb has to be up. I'm a silly goose. Might adjust her fingers later. Like the inking stage or something. Cause this is giving me like a lot of struggle. Man. People do that as a meme, but... I mean, at least with the 89, like, if they have the 89 gear, right? Then... I guess it probably doesn't matter, you know? Because, like, that gear isn't gonna get anything, right? They're just gonna... What is it? Replace it soon anyway. Honestly, I think it might depend more on what? I think it really depends. I usually struggle with hands, but, like, also with, like, stylization also, you know? Because, like, stylizing something is also pretty hard. And since I have, like, this, like, very, I guess, semi-chibi-esque style, like, it's also hard to get those proportions right, so... Oh, if they were in 90 gear, then I guess, yeah. My instinct is, well, if they're in the 89 gear, I mean, they could just be doing it for, like, achievement's sake, you know? Anyway, I'm kind of warming up with this. So, I think this should be... Wait, no, her hair goes in front, I think. And then we have these little... Noses are pretty easy because, like, at least in most anime styles, like, all you have to draw is a little dot. It really depends on, like, your style, I think, as well. Also, hi, Doc! Sorry. That's the doorbell. It's not Haru. It's very quiet today. It doesn't even feel like I should be streaming because, like, it feels weird. Yeah, I do. But like... I can't imagine myself doing anything but the usual. I think her eyeball is too off. Oops. Nope. I'm trying to get this, like, sketch down. Like, for a sticker or something. Her eyes look spooky when I draw them like this. Like, I don't know about other people's opinion about Identity V, but personally, I have this, like, slight dislike of it because I don't like the button eyes. I love her eyes in this case. I actually really like Ai-chan's eyes. I think this part is a little too low. But right now, like, it's just a sort of sketch. Well done. I actually think it's more distracting on, what is it? It's more distracting on Ruby and Aqua. Than it is on, I think because both of her eyes are, it's actually not that bad in my opinion. It's where it's only one of the eyes that I'm like, okay, that's a little distracting. See, again, I think it's very much about what style. Like, if you're going for realism, of course, nose is going to be kind of very different than a lot of more stylized pieces. Noses are typically, like, not really paid attention to. In style, more stylized things. Same with, like, getting the art. Like, for an eye, even. If you're running a more stylized, style, like... The main thing is that hands usually have to like hold on to things. They have to interact with the world around the character. That's why it usually doesn't matter what style that they're doing. Eyes can, or hands can be trouble. Like, I actually really like drawing eyes, so... I think a lot of people... enjoy drawing eyes and adding all, like, the fanciful elements to them. But hands are more, like, because eyes, you know, they say eyes are the window to the soul or whatever, and stuff like that. So a lot of people put, like, a lot of energy into making the eyes very attention-grabbing. But hands are, in my opinion, more functional than anything else. Hands have to be on the functional side of things. Which is what kind of makes them harder. Plus, there's a lot of parts, you know? There's like... 5 goddamn fingers, right? Wait, does she have a ponytail and I just can't really see it because of the black background? Yeah, she does. Okay. Shit. Oh, heads up, add in 20 or so seconds. I also have a commission to work on tonight, so we'll be doing that after I kind of do, oops, this. Yeah, after we finish, like, kind of warming up, making a sticker slash keychain design, I guess, I will be doing a commission work to get that done. I did wake up pretty late today, but it ended up being okay because I still finished parts that I wanted to. For subtitle timing on P8S. So I'm at about halfway typing out all the subtitles. A little over, I think, because it's a little under 40 minutes. So hopefully I can indeed get it done by this weekend. I also need to start thinking about what to draw for the FanFest contest entry. As much as, like, I can't work on it yet. Just because I need to do the video work first. But... I should probably, like, sketch something out. Maybe, like, in my sketchbook or something. In Kofi, yes, two requests. For two characters, yes. A little too hard on that pen pressure. Too warm. Yeah, I did order, sticker proofs. Well, sticker samples. And like I said, one of them, they actually send, like, your own design, a custom one. So those are technically sellable. But the main purpose is just to see whether or not they look good. Man, why do I feel, like, very untalkative today? Like, I feel like I just kind of want to sit in quiet. Weird. Maybe because it's so quiet in the house, you know? Sorry if I'm a little on the quieter side today. I know I say that a lot, but... you know? Are you guys working on the Mog Tome collection? I gotta get started on that. Because I need the Porxy earring. Yeah, that started today. It's for a while though, you know? Here we are. Friends are. My friend. We all of the dark deep inside you. Find a light again. Time turning how we seek events. Ugh. To be fair, yeah, the only thing I really want from it is the Porxy earring, and that's kind of it. I think I have everything else, so... kinda take it easy, sort of. As somebody who pretty much logs in every day, I find it weird to just not log in. You know? I'm not saying, like, you have to play, like, as religiously as me. It's just one of those weird things. Like, I was talking with Joey the other day. Another thing where it's like, I guess it makes sense. But, like, the idea that, like, some people don't just, like, have ideas to create is so weird to me. Like, how do you just sit there and only consume? How do you never have ideas that you actually want to try to make real? Okay, though. A little quieter than usual today. But, yeah. Like, not all of my friends were, like, artists or whatever. Back in school. But, I don't know, like, it feels weird to be like... there really are people that just... consume. And they don't, like, create too. Yeah, we're drawing a bit of a thing for maybe stickers. Maybe she would look good with, like, sparkles. Like a sparkly print on, like the sticker material? Nope. She does have like one of these sort of pointy... I feel like, well, like, I don't stop by very often because I don't wake up early enough. I feel like when I do wake up, I often see that she's had to cancel stream a lot. I hope she's doing okay. Oh, She keeps microwaving her tea? Doesn't she know that that's more danger? Cause like, basically, it's more possible to boil the water so hot that it like... Hold on. Doesn't, at least this is something I think I remember hearing, like, that it doesn't like, bubble. And so like, when you, you know, like, put your spoon into it or something, it could like explode. Oh no no, please take it easy, Bangy. Thank you for stopping by regardless. There you go. Thank you for the sip as well. I will in a sec. Yeah, Ruby's a friend of mine from when I was in Japan. Well, actually before then, but... Now, like, there have been, like... I was watching this one, like... debunking thing. I mean, their one main thing is, like, it is super dangerous to microwave an egg, but like they mentioned about like microwaving water, and like occasionally you can microwave it like so hot that it doesn't bubble like when it normally boils. I think it's actually more about the purity of it, right? But anyway, like there's a chance that like it doesn't bubble, and then when you put something in it, it just goes, like, actually explodes. And, like, that's very dangerous. See, I might do less, just because I have less water in there. So it's technically less tea, so if I let it go for the full 2 to 3 minutes... it might be too strong. But I don't, like, calculate it either, so I don't know. I just go, that looks about right. There are, but like, not for like every, that's for like specialty. You're not gonna do that normally. No one's doing tea ceremonies in their house to make a cup of tea. Well, most people aren't. There might be one person that does.
Thank you.
didn't like peppermint, but I like milk tea. And I usually get, I don't know where you live, May, but there's Celestial Seasonings, which I think is like a major brand in like various parts. And I like the Sleepy Time. And the chamomile honey, and I think there's something else in it. But I always put honey, even more honey in it. I think it has small amounts, but it depends on the tea. Celestial Seasonings, I think, is not. Green tea I have as well. Especially for like when my throat hurt. But milk tea, you'd have to like import it, by the way, which is my main tea. Like, unless you're in Japan, then you can buy it. Maybe some other Asian countries too. The tea cow, okay. Yeah, there's definitely milk in it. If you've had like bubble tea, it's also probably the main version that you find. The milk tea version. It's like that, but you can have it hot too. Oh, her joint is funny. I'm actually more so-so on bubble tea because I don't really like the tapiocas. And I don't like using the straw and then suddenly tapioca fall and you're like, ugh. And I'm like, I didn't want this. I do like the slushy kind where it's like more for summer and stuff, so that I like. I like that more than the standard bubble tea, honestly. Let me do her hair thingy. Let me just draw the circle first. No! No. Hehehe. Okay, and then she has a regular bow. Whoa! Here she's got the tails with the cutout on them. Oh, really? Have they stopped with their DIY yet, or are they still going? They're still going? Well, that's annoying. Are they doing it right now? Is this DIY neighbor in the room with us? No! No NordVPN. Shoo. This curve is not coming out the way I want it to. Oh, I see, I see. I hope whatever it is, it comes out good, but that they also finish it soon, you know? Sponsored by NordVPN. Doc likes to spread misinformation on the internet. That's just more misinformation. Eyeballs. Most important part. But I'm right. You like to spread misinformation in chat, especially. You just did. Right index finger. No. I need her eyebrows. My eyebrows are a little too far apart. I moved her nose. That was part of the problem. But I also think this eye is too far from her nose. Alright, and I think some of these inner lines need more. What the hell is line weight? Hard. To that, I only do this on Ryza days. Literally spreading misinformation yesterday. Alternate truths? I don't know. In what universe? No, I didn't. That's literally gaslighting. That's not okay. No. Wait, for what? Put what on my wish list? I don't want to do that. It's not even... No! 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 You won't, because we're not doing that. I don't want to do an easy bake oven stream. I don't want to do a cooking stream. No! I'm just gonna go back to drawing. That should be fine. Maybe I'll just cut it down to two layers and put the yellow here. Oh, that's not supposed to be that type of layer. I hope I didn't accidentally cover some of the yellow. God damn it, I keep hitting vector layer. Oh. I missed a spot. No, I said I don't think the joke was very funny. And I feel like it was going on for too long, so... Oh no, it's okay, May. I wasn't saying it directly anyway. Oh, I need to put this collar up here. And then the pink is this part. And then I guess you use this yellow on the bunny. I guess that's a different kind of... I'm gonna reduce colors. God damn it. I like missed half a pixel. Oh my god, bunny ear! There you go. Don't worry, she'll have a mouth back eventually. Eventually. Her eyeball's back. Not her mouth. She already has her mouth. Oops, I missed a spot. There you go. I don't know what this is from. Oh, that's the ribbons. Okay. Okay. Yeah, I want her hair to be this, like, dark purple. I don't want to grab her, Actually, I can probably just put it underneath everything else and then just fill in whatever. Oh, there's... That's not supposed to be filled. Oh my god! There you go. Oh, there's a spot there that's got skin tone that's not supposed to. This doesn't have that. This doesn't have that. This needs this erased. And then she has her pink streakies. I almost kind of want to put it with, like... one of these, like... sparklies. You know? Oh, this is Ai from Oshinoko. Well, maybe I'll add the effect after. I'll do... this for now. I'll add the effects and stuff later. Yeah, it's a current season thing. No, like legit, it's a lot of people are like, oh, you don't want to know what it's about before you go into it. And I think they're kind of right. I mean, I can't stop anybody, right? From, like, deciding to look shit up. Can't stop anybody. I don't think it's genre change. It just, I mean... maybe? But I don't really think of things in terms of genre anyway too much. Man, Sunhaven's on sale for like... how much off? Oh shoot, I hope it... well, I mean, I guess the microwave turns off, so you're probably fine. It's just probably cold now, right? That sucks. Sunhaven's on 20% sale. So it's like only 20 bucks now, but like... we're still playing Ryza. Right? And... I feel like it's one of those games I'd end up playing off-stream. Alright, her eyes are very, like... I have to deal with her eyes super special. So for right now, they're just gonna be like this. She's cute, she has a fun color palette. I really like her hair, it's very fun. Actually, wait a minute! She has my favorite color palette! Purple, pink, yellow! No wonder I think she looks really cute! Her purple's darker than I usually go with, but like... damn! No fucking wonder! Alright, so I'm gonna also do... is this... delete that to clean it up. Move that here. Merge these together. Okay. Alright, all the layers have been colored. They're all good. I can close this. Oh, shoot. There's a little spot that shouldn't have color here. There you go. No wonder I think her color combo is really nice. And then the two other characters, the two other major characters that are in the show have the cotton candy aesthetic that I also really like. Where like one of them is blue and one of them is pink. Man, that's good shit. Cotton candy aesthetic, but also like this. That's good shit. The VTuber meme song is good. Yeah, I wouldn't play it on stream because I don't want to get in trouble. But you can just search up Yoasobi. The song time is a title is Idol. I mean, anything Yoasobi is pretty good. Oh. I wish I had more time to watch, like, before. I think it was, what, this week? Last week? At this point? Because now I feel like I'm behind on all, like, the draw the character thing going on. Which, like, I know that's not important. One of those where you're like, man, I wish I had been on the... In this case, it was just a matter of I didn't have time. I didn't have time to sit down and watch an anime. The first episode is an hour long! I was like, wait, is this real? I was like, is this like... correct? Is there something going on here? No, it really was an hour long. I mean, it made sense by the time I finished watching it, but I was like, what? What? Is that still counted as one episode? Is it a... do we know... wait, how many cores is it supposed to be? Is it a one or two core? How long it's gonna be? From what I hear, I mean, there's more arcs in the story, right? So, in the manga version. I mean, obviously. It's still on. It was still ongoing when I left, I think. And I think they had already announced the anime, so... I remember looking at the girl on the cover, Ai-chan, and being like, damn, she cute, but I'm reading other stuff right now. So I didn't pick it up. But I'll probably pick it up whenever we next go into the city, when we go to Kinokuniya. Assuming they have, like, number one in stock or something. Otherwise, I might have to order it online or something. Holy crap! That's wild. Magic... microwave cuts off your power. What was May cooking that set off the power? After, like, the... also what time it is when I finish the commission and this piece. We'll see if I still want to... keep going. Because, like I said, I'm kind of off today. You know? So, I do want to get some stuff done that has to get done. Like, commission. And probably the thumbnail. But we'll see how I feel after that. Are you gonna be okay? Probably. It's real life, not fiction, you know? One thing I will say about Oshinoko is that I very rarely want to re-watch a show a second time while it's still airing. And Oshinoko is one of those ones where like I actually kind of want to re-watch it. Maybe I'll watch it a third time if Joey wants to watch it together. And we hook up the TV to my computer. Or something. I don't know if he is interested or not. Yeah, sorry I was like kind of grumpy about the easy bake and the paint drying streams thing before. I'm not doing a cooking stream. That, like, is never happening. No. Like, 100% never happening. I might actually... I remember I have my brownies. We bought brownie mix, though. I might... make them... for my sister... visits? We'll see. And then Haru can have some when he comes back from his vacation. Well, not vacation. His work. His work trip. It feels weird. It's so quiet. But I also think I'm having one of those days where it's like I kind of just want to sit in silence a bit. So maybe, yeah, after we get some artwork done that I need to get done, I might end on the earlier side just so I can have... nothing is wrong, just quiet time. Like I said, I might even watch Oshinoko again. Literally. That's what I mean, like, I like the style, I like what it did. I'm hoping that the rest of the show doesn't disappoint. But I think this is one of those few cases where I'm like, you know what? The general anime fandom populace is correct. This is good show. Absolutely wild, I know. For once, they might actually have, like... a good taste. We'll see, though. I'm a little hesitant. But at the very least, I like the characters. I like the character design a lot. I really like the starry eyes. I love the extra effort that's put into their eyeballs. The main characters. I think it looks very pretty. I also gotta watch Pretty Cure. Is this week's up? Hold on, let me check. Crunchyroll. Hold on a sec. Let me just see if I'm behind or not. Yeah, there's another episode. Okay. I gotta watch this week's Pretty Cure as well. not keep my... I might keep myself off on that. Just because, like, I don't wanna... What's it? I don't wanna... get myself hype and then not be able to find it when we go to Japan. Oh yeah, when does Miku thingy on? I'm double checking when the announcements for the tickets. Because I applied... I think... I have to double check whether or not you can apply more than one. It says if you apply for multiple performances, you may be attributed more than one ticket. So I think I can apply for multiple. When is it announced? Does it say? I mean, it ends on May 22nd, the ticket sales for the English version of the site. One thing I did realize, though, is that even if I don't get concert tickets, right? I can still go to the exhibition. It's only like 500 yen a pop, right? Like... if I remember correctly, yeah, it's 500 and it's only... there that day. Yeah, 500 yen to get in to the exhibition hall. But you only get, like, one day... You get one day included with your concert ticket, but the exhibition you have to buy on the day of. So the good thing is that even if we don't get the concert, Joey and I could go together to the exhibition hall, you know? That was one thing I was like, still we could have a day, a Miku day. Yeah. Yeah, no, it's usually pretty crowded. Oh, that's cool. I don't want to apply for the accommodation plan, but that's cool. They have exclusive merch, like... look at that. That's really cool for a luggage tag. And then they have a mesh bag. Look at the good vibes. Good vibes. I like how it looks like 63 when the 39 is upside down. I'm not applying for this though. This has like a... I think it also has a hotel and everything involved in it. It's a pretty expensive deal, but you get exclusive bonuses. It looks like those are the two. Actually, I'm just curious. I'm gonna go look. I'm not applying for it. I'm just curious. There's A, B, C, D, E, F. They're all for different days and you only get the one... Wow, okay. Does it say how much they are? I'm just curious. They include SS tickets. Does that say how much they are? So the ticket is 9,700 yen. Does it... where does it cost for the other thing? Oh my goodness, it's like 23,000 to 25,000. The cheapest ones are like 17,000 yen. Damn, that's expensive. That's an expensive hotel stay. It's... that said, like, some of these are, like... right by... right in Kaihin Makuhari. So, like, you don't take a train. You walk to the concert. Damn, that's expensive. I was just curious how much those were. It was a curiosity thing, because I always know that they... at least they used to do these way more often. Like, Eventer... like, I had a few people that were kind of in the Eventer space. That I knew. And... so I always kind of knew about the existence of accommodation plans, but I'd never... and I knew that there are them for the... Japanese... tourists to go to, like... events as well. And I'd always kind of wondered how much they were. I remember the exhibition hall, so Mika usually does three halls. I remember correctly at Makuhari. Hold on, I can take a look. Does it say which halls? 9. So the concert. Can they show me the inside? Maybe? Fudoa map. Okay. So I can show you. Where's Chrome? I don't have it. Okay. Window capture. Chrome. Please don't freak out, OBS. I'm begging you. Okay. Wah! Hi. Okay. Wait, over is CSP. So. The concert is this hall. 9. Here. Oh, I can't zoom in. Hold on, PDF. Zoom it. So, Miku is... The concert is this hall. I don't know how many square feet that is. Or meters, even. The event exhibition is 10 and 11, so it's right next door. These two, which is, I think, about the same when you put them together. So, this entire area is Miku. So, this is where the concert will be. And then this is where the exhibition, these two rooms, they'll collapse and combine. Let me see if it tells you how big they are. Does it tell you how big they are? I don't know. Let's Google it. How big is Makuhari Messe Hall 11? Or Hall 9? Has 9,000 square meters. Oh. Why is this text so small? Why? Anyway, what? I think I saw something roll over and it's just gone now. Weird. Why is this text so small? Yeah, like this is it with nothing in it. Pretty big! Okay. Well, see, I think I was the only one that noticed him, because I think... Because it was when I was walking to meet up with Ruby. Yeah, it's a pretty big exhibition hall. Space is pretty big. And then, yeah, I think 9 and 10 where the exhibition is. Honestly, I think they've actually done a pretty good job overall. With, like... What is it? Spacing things out. It's definitely felt cramped, but not like it's definitely felt busy, you know, like it's definitely felt like there are a lot of people, but I don't think it ever really felt like cramped. It didn't feel like claustrophobic like Comic-Con did those few times that, you know, we went. Like Comic-Con literally felt like I was gonna have a panic attack. But like, they've got a lot of space. And they've also like spread it out so that it doesn't feel claustrophobic. So they do a really... I mean, they've also been running this for now 11 years, Magical Mirai. And even before then, there was Miku's Giving Day. And I think another Miku concert. So... it's not even about the, oh, haha, no one showers. It's literally just... everybody is all crammed extremely tightly. It's more like... just trying to get through, it feels like there's no space. It's like being in a can of sardines. It's like being on a packed rush hour train in Tokyo. Where your like flight or fight reaction activates and you're like, I need to get out of here. But like Miku had things pretty spread out. There were actually spaces for people to, like, sit. And honestly, outside of, like, people wait... like, the only time you really notice how many people there are is, like, in the merch line. And even then, people give each other space. Nobody's, like, squishing you forward, really. And it's just the one merch booth, right? That's, like, really popular. It's the official one. And, you know, people... Like, I went to Miku, right? In New York. And I remember the merch booth. And honestly, it was so poorly organized there. It is, like, you were pretty much fighting to get it in there. But yeah, like, the stalls and layouts... the team that does Magical Mirai... have it down, like, big time. And yeah, there's usually a giant Miku statue. But like, she's there for also taking pictures. But yeah, I'd say it's more like an expo than like just a standard concert. Like the exposition is an actual exposition and it's just very open. They're not trying to cram as much as they can into a tiny space, which I think a lot of conventions do the opposite of. And I think in some cases that's important, but like also like it can be very stressful for, you know, visitors. And it kind of makes people like me anyway not necessarily want to go to those sorts of events, right? They have a lot of stuff behind glass in Miku. Because they have a lot of things that are being showcased before they're officially released. Like over at Good Smile and stuff. Like they have a lot of shit that's like, a lot of figures are like pre-release. They're not out yet. So they have a lot of things. They also have really nice lighting. They also, some things, like I think 1 year before, really early on in, Project Sekai's pretty early on in Project Sekai's life, right? They were showcasing Dolphy, Project Sekai Miku, but it's like, what is it? The Project Sekai one for the depressed girls. Nigoji, or whatever. Nigo, right? Nijugoji de naito koldo de. They actually had a picture. There's a sign that says no pictures allowed because she was too prototype, and they hadn't given the company. So, like, I think it's Craftig. The companies involved hadn't given their full permission to, like, show it out in the open. So, like, they could show it at the expo, but people couldn't take pictures of it. Yeah, they have a really good handle on it as the expo stuff, honestly. It's very organized. It felt very it's never, to me anyway, felt like claustrophobic and stuff. I've like, don't get me wrong. Like, it's still crowded, but I don't feel like suffocated. I don't feel like I'm gonna like I need to panic and get out of there, you know? I don't feel that sort of panic at Miku. You feel like you can actually you can kind of wander about freely without too much worry. And people also are pretty respectful about everybody wanting to take pictures of certain things. You kind of wait for the person in front of you, and then. I mean, yeah, I've shown pictures from the last ones. You get very good shots. Even with the crowd, like, it's not too crowded that it's hard to take pictures of certain things. And people kind of give enough space for pictures. And because everybody knows that everyone wants to take pictures of it, you know? Like, everybody knows that if pictures are allowed, people want to take pictures of the upcoming Miku figures because they're so pretty. Everybody there knows, you know? They want to take pictures too, so they're going to be respectful to everybody else wanting to take pictures. It's kind of one of those where, like, of course, like, everybody wants to do this, so of course we're gonna be respectful to the other people that are wanting to do it, you know? So. Right, I wanna do hers. Her eye shine. Her hair shines as, like. You know, her eye thingy. The six-sided star. That's true as well. Like, if I get a table, like, it'll be. Like, I can always just kind of retreat behind the table. This is true. Now, I think what I want to kind of do. I'm gonna see if I like it. Put this sparkle stuff on it. Yeah, I kind of like that. Thank you. Maybe. I still have to apply. I've prepared a lot of stuff, but there's like a couple things that I want to do before I actually apply. So I haven't yet. Oh no, absolutely. I have the thingy. What is it? The 19th? I have the date on my board, so. It's more just I like, you know, I needed an actual portfolio page and stuff like that. Which is like, oh, I don't really have one of those, like, proper. You know? Where it's like, okay. Plus I need to like sit down and be like, okay, I'm gonna sell these things. There's one more thing I wanna do is particular for the entire thing is that I really wanna have I have a couple of like older sticker thingies. So I really wanna like I want to take a couple pictures of them as, like, physical merch. So. I guess I should probably remember to do that tomorrow. Because I was so busy working on, the video stuff today. I think her eyes are a little crooked. The star in her eye here. There you go. But now I need to clean it because it looks ugly like this. One thing, like, I hate about rotating things. I should have done this that one way that allows it to not do that, which is the vector layer, but oh well. There you go. Now I need to do it for the other eyeball. There you go. Almost. Oops. Oh, I see. Well, I hope you can get it done. Yeah, a lot of my stuff is like, okay, I should do that. But then, like, I'm like, okay, but I really want to make sure I finish this, like, that video before this weekend. Mm-hmm. guys are so, like, cute, but I can't fucking draw them good. They looked okay, but not, like, good. Her eyes are tricky. You got someone's name wrong? Oh my gosh. I think... these should be closer. Bring her with me once more. That looked better. Do I still have my reference? No. Okay, let me go pull her up again. History. Where's her image? That. No, they're actually further apart. Okay. Actually, I think these might be fine. This is so hard. Her eyes are so difficult. Like, to get these, like, shines just right, they're driving me insane. I think they're super cute. They're driving me insane. Oh, Emmy didn't react. Emmy probably did though either. Ask him if he knew. Like when you noticed. Love these eyes. Why am I struggling? These will look fine like as a sketch, but like a minute I try to get them to look like right rendered. In this case, it's more about like making the star correct, and if I had to, I can squish it, right? Because, like, in her case, it's important that this be, like, a six-sided star. Okay. I do think that this could be squished more. Yeah, I'm using the mirror for her eye, like, to make it... the star shape correct. Like, that's the reason I'm really using it, to make sure that this star shape is the right shape. Because I think if I was, like, if I had, like, a shape tool with it, I'd probably just use that, at least to get the base of it. Yeah, no, these are better. But in her case, with her eye stars, like, I definitely want to get them, like, the right colors. I definitely want to be like, okay, no. That's the right... like, I definitely want to get it, like... the right six-sided star shape. No? Because I think that's pretty important for her, like, as a design. It's a major design element. The layer mask, mask outside selection. I don't like this texture. I like it, but I don't like it, you know what I mean? I think I need to use... No. Well, maybe. Nah, not this kind of pattern. It's more of like the starry sky kind of thing. You know? It's gotta be pretty small because it's in her eyeballs. Using multiply? No. This is hard to make it right. What if I just go full black? Does it still work? I don't think so. Doesn't really show. Correction, brightness, contrast. Contrast, like, bump it up a heck. There we go. And then go, like, glow. And then I think I want Midgen more of fun shenanigans with sparkles. Because she has very pretty eyes. She has very pretty starry sky eyes. They're very pretty. Mm-hmm. Hi, zombie, how are you? Of course I'm gonna be using my fancy brushes. It'd be like, you want to use metallic paint when you want something that's metallic-y. Neh? So. It's using the right paint for the job. In this case, it's a brush. Alright, and I think I want duplicating this. And then going filter, blur, Gaussian blur. Hey, no, there's not. You would want to use the correct brush. You would want it's the same thing. You want to use the correct brush for the job. You wouldn't want to use a fan brush when you're trying to paint a person. I'm right. There's a specific purpose for a fan brush, or a thin brush, or a wide brush, or a fat brush, or a sponge brush. Just like there's a different purpose for my different brushes. And you know, I'm right. My analogy is still valid. Yeah, we need some more titanium. I don't actually use very much white. But we're adding some titanium white to her eyeball. Zombie. We are adding some nice titanium white to her eye. For her very bright, lovely, sparkly, starry eyes. As you can see here. You guys think Bob Ross would like digital art? Now that I think about it. What do you think his opinion on was he around when digital art became like really popular? Or not really? No AI. Alright, I think I want these to be a little bigger. Let me just like spot that there. Well, like, was he around when digital art became a thing? I don't know. Oh, I gotta move this. Just a smidgen, so I have more space. Look at her pretty eyes. Very pretty. I put a lot of energy in the... Oh, really? Damn. They probably... Maybe he has some idea. Let's go ask Google. What did Bob Ross think about digital art? Wow, that's actually a thing. It'll finish. Well, it doesn't answer me. I don't know. Perhaps he like saw like some of the earlier stuff and was just like, I mean, it's still art. Because it shouldn't matter what medium you do, as long as you make art. Art! Like that one... Wait, what movie was that from? Is it from The Iron Giant or whatever? That movie used to be on like Cartoon Network like all the goddamn time. What did, well, didn't it? So before anybody goes like, oh damn, you saw that movie? Of course I did. I swear it was on like Cartoon Network all the damn time. Also, Mika, thank you for the follow. Welcome to the Comfy Cave. Because I know somebody's gonna be like, wait, you watched Iron Guy? It was on Cartoon Network all the goddamn time. Everyone saw it. If you watch Cartoon Network, you saw it. They just played it constantly. I'm not saying that as a bad thing, I'm just saying it as a fact. You know? We shall live on. Oh, I missed a spot on our eyeball line. There we go. There we go. There we go. Sparkly, pretty eyeballs. Oh, there's a couple spots I need to fix up on the shading here. And light again. Okay, there's a couple of little wonky spots. Or because they're like right in between two different like particles, they, you know. And oh yeah, Bob Ross would totally not like AIs. Cause like, I'm pretty sure Bob Ross probably like believed in the human imagination. Probably? Question mark? I guess that would be my take, right? I think a lot of artists, I think also like, even if you were like, AI art is like, I think AI art can be a really interesting tool, but only a tool for people to create. Cause like, somebody pointed out like the AI is just doing what it can, you know? Like it doesn't know what a hand is. The computer doesn't know what a hand is. It just knows that these general shapes are, go here. You know what I mean? Yeah, and it's also only limited by its programming. Also, I don't quite... This is not quite smooth enough for me. And the worst part is that there will be people that have a style that's aesthetically somewhat similar to the common, like, art style that robots will be using. And then they get accused of doing AI art. And it's like, no, you can look at some of these art and go, no, that looks like a person drew it, you know? And I feel really bad for those people. I guess that's one good thing about my art style, being a little bit non-standard anime. I'm sure that the computer could do it. I'm not gonna find out. But I'm sure it could. I'm sure it could create a style similar to mine. But, you know, it would never be my art. Nah. It would, like, the thing is, people point out how, like, a lot of the AI stuff, like, the lines just stop making sense. Where it's like, yeah, like if you look at them like in enough, like if you look at them closely enough, they stop making, like their ways of doing simple, like basic strokes stop making sense. Like a human wouldn't have simplified it down that way. Is, I guess, the difference. Also, hi, Hiei, how are you? We're drawing Oshinoko. Because for once, the general anime populace has a good taste in anime that I agree with. Oh, you have something? Well, I hope it goes smoothly. Well, also that I had time to actually watch again. That's the other part. Oh! Don't forget water. Stay hydrated. Water good, as Stahl says. I hope you have a good walk. And yeah, I think a lot of us will be able, like, I think at first glance, it's very easy to make the mistake of mixing up an AI. Like, I think that's what I mean. Like, at first glance, yeah, absolutely. Like, with a quick glance, I think AI can blend in. But if you start to, like, actually look at it, it totally falls apart, you know? Some people are not going to have the time or energy to do that scrutiny, and I don't blame them. But... oh, yeah! Speaking of, sort of speaking? Or sort of related. So, okay, I've heard about how... so, you know that Samsung phone thing where, like, apparently it fakes pictures of the moon when you zoom in? So lately, since I live in the States now, I get, like, US ads. I get English-speaking ads on my, Twitter feed. And every once in a while now, I'm getting that Samsung phone ad. And right underneath it is that warning of misinformation. About how their phones just aren't actually taking a picture of the moon. They're using AI to make it cleaner. Which is absolutely hilarious. Like, that's... I feel it's kind of funny that that's in their ad. That their ad has that on underneath it. It's so funny that their ad has that right underneath it. Okay, I think she came out really nice. She would make a good sticker, right? This cute little chibi. Mm. Oh, really?
I see.
It was a story about an artist using AI.
Oh.
Literally, like, predicting the future. What do you guys think? What do you guys think of this? Good sticker? How big is this? It's 300 DPI. I don't know how big this is. Image resolution. Can I tell how many images? This is 6.5 inches. It's huge. I wouldn't have a sticker this big though. But it's better to work. Right now it's at 2K by 2K. And at 300 DPI. If I intend to print it, I need to work at 300 DPI. Alright. So, one thing... okay, one other thing that happened when I actually put it... hold on, I can show you which one I sent in for the proofs. This is what I applied for proofs with. I sent Sticker Ninja this one, because I think this one would look really nice and it probably would go well. I also might look into, like, the cost difference between getting it as a standard matte sticker and a holographic sticker. Because I think maybe her eyes would be cool and holographic. Maybe, like, her hair... I don't know. Maybe I'll leave it normal for this one. But I think Oshinoko, like, her eyes absolutely, and maybe the pink, have to be holographic. Absolutely. These would have to be holographic. So, yeah. But I also, they actually were, like, warning me that this text here and this text here might not be readable, and that's fine. I just left my signatures to leave my signatures for the proof. Actually, I'm gonna do one more little bit. Her eyes are so good. Personally, mentor the android. Yeah, it's definitely a big important thing to think about. I think the pink in her hair, the hair shines, and the eyes would be what I would want sparkly. I would want holographic. It's not too much holographic, but I definitely think that that this show, especially the eyes, would be really good if they are holographic for like a sticker. I think in the future, I won't include my name on it. Like, I'll see how it looks, if it even looks readable at all. But I might just keep my signature on it, regardless. But yeah, I could definitely see, like, Hoshinoko, if I were to do her kids too, which I think I probably would. If I were to do her, I think Aqua and Ruby should be done as well. But for now, we're just gonna do Aicha. I think I would have their one eye sparkly. And the other one not. I feel like you could put like a lot of energy in her eyeball. It's so much fun. Like, I'm just gonna say, it's fun to put a lot of energy in her eye. You know? But yeah, I would definitely do Ruby and Aqua as well. Yeah, I could absolutely with Sticker Ninja. They kind of do it as well. But like, I can be like, I would like this part. And then they send me a proof. So in this case, I would be like, the pink part of her hair, her eyes, and then the hair shines. So I could probably send them a second file of it, of just the white overlay, and then yeah, there's a proofing stage that you confirm and stuff. I assume that would be true for the other ones, but the difference in price is gonna be a matter of, but I think that for Hoshinoko, I think regardless, I think with Miku, I might leave it like just plain, but I think with Oshinoko, like, I think it's like at a bare minimum, her eyes have to be holographic. I think that's like super great for a sticker. The other thing I was thinking about, let me use Raha. Where's Raha? Where's Raha Pop? I might actually duplicate him now. So, what I want to do in the future, maybe not right away, if I get into Art and Artist Alley, I'd probably get it ready. But I want it, like, maybe crop around his, like, scarf and have double-sided, what is it? Double-sided acrylic keychain. So one side is this face and the other side is this face. So you actually have the pop cat, like, live. You could spin it around and it'd have a pop cat. And I'd probably want to do Yashtola as well. But yeah, like I said, like a double-sided acrylic keychains are a little more on the more expensive side, but also double-sided acrylic keychains are a little bit more, are obviously more expensive, so. But yeah, I think that would be like a fantastic idea for them. All right, all right, I'm gonna grab a drink. I'm trying to think what tea I want, but I also gotta go to the bathroom. Alright, let me at least sketch this out, right? And then, yeah, like, I have a lot of cool ideas, especially these days. I also was thinking that maybe, at least at first, I think the 14 drinks, even if I just do the healer set, I'd probably, I'd probably get them glossy first, Because, like, their drinks, I think glossy would suit them better. But then maybe in the future, again, holographic on certain parts or something. I just think holographic stickers are really cool. I'm aiming for smaller size stickers. Maybe some will be the 3-inch, but personally, I think I like between 2 and 2.5 better. I think that they fit more on the journal that I use often. I think they're more versatile that way because they're smaller. Oh heck, I broke a nail a bit. I was wondering what the heck is that little bit that like scratched me? It was my nail. I'm fine, it's just tiny. I was just like, what the heck? You always like jump to like, are you okay? I'm fine. I was just like, what the fuck is this? Yeah, sometimes like your nail just kind of like snap, like a little bit of it like snaps or whatever. I don't know. No, it's fine. I just think it's funny. I'm just like, oh damn. Totally fine reaction. Just like, yeah. Oh, well, that's annoying. I think they don't have eyelashes, so while I'm not 100% sure, because they don't have eyelashes and they're rough, I will not include them. Alright, I'm gonna sketch out like just this hair and then yeah. I do, by the way, if anybody's ever wondering like where I might prefer to be commissioned in the future, I am really liking VGen a lot. It has like its own waitlist function. It actually has like a lot of people will use like Trello and stuff. I personally, I had one in the past. Yeah, it's a new site. I had a Trello in the past, but it's one of those things where it's just like I struggle to really keep it updated. It, for kind of two reasons. One, either I finish it so fast that I like, there's kind of like no reason for me to like put it up, it feels like. So then I forget. Or alternatively, like I just forget that I have a Trello. So I ended up like I have one and then I just kind of stopped using. I think people did, but it becomes like a bit of a struggle to like make and get like a solid base for, like, we have Skeb, right? But that's got a very specific subset of commissions. And I think with the popularity of Skeb, particularly in the VTuber sphere, there have been people requesting it. And I'm not entirely sure the exact names of the people behind VGen, but they've done a very good job, like, yeah. And we're soon, I think one of their next things that they're working on is basically the equivalent of DMs. So you won't need to use Twitter anymore to contact them if there's a problem. Which is honestly currently a problem because Twitter DMs like fucking don't work. Like I've had people, I think it was like Kiki when I did some work for, when I did some pops for them, and they were like, I tried to message you on Twitter but it doesn't work. And I'm like, yeah, I know. I think I've been aware for like a couple of weeks ever since the pops. I'm like, I feel bad because I'm like, I can't message these people on Twitter. All right, I have finished this sketch. I am gonna put us on burp. I'm gonna boil the water and then I'm gonna decide what kind of tea or drink I want. But I also gotta go to the bathroom. So I will be right back, chat. I return! Okay. My chair slid a bit over though. Okay. Let me turn that off. Okay. Blah. Okay. I got the standard milk tea. Maybe later I'll have some sleepy time. You know what I realized while I was, waiting for it? Is that today, because Joey is not sitting there, at his desk, so there's no risk of it getting knocked over. I can sit with my tea on his desk and read on that side of the bed and not have to reach over myself to get to the what's it called? The side table. End table? The bed, yeah, end table, Joey desk, computer, mouse, yeah. Normally my side is here. Mimi's side here. But I'm a righty. So to get this tea, like, I have to, like, turn and, like, reach my arm around. So now, tonight, I could decide to read book, and my tea can go here. Easy. Yeah, he's a lefty. It's not a problem when it's the bed. When we sit at restaurants, I sit on the... where my right arm's on the outside. Look, I just like the left side of the bed. It's not even... actually, no, it's not even about the left side or the right side. It's like, whenever I first lay in the bed, I'm like... there's a specific direction. It's arbitrary. Where, like, I like facing that direction. So I lay on my side. I prefer facing out, generally. And so... on the bed, I like to lay east way. So, I like facing out. So if I were to do that over here, that'd be weird. Because I'd be facing east way. In. I don't like ye. It's not even like I prefer my left side or my right side. It's that, like... I just have a feeling for which side I like facing. You know what I mean? Like, I lay in the bed, I'm like, yes, this way. If there's like, if it's against a wall, then it's easy. But in this case, it's in the middle of the room, so it's a little harder. So it's just like, I kind of sat on the bed and I'm like, yep, I like this side. I stole his end table. But also, like, that's where his desk is. Like, it makes more sense that his desk is where he can put... his glasses. You know what I mean? It makes sense that, like... that's his side. Because that's where his desk is. That's the side his desk is on, too. So to me, that also makes more sense, you know? Yeah, I had, I actually want to get one of those, like, foldable tea trays, or I guess... you know, the things that people use for, like, bed and breakfast. Eventually, I want to get one of those. So that I could have it, I could have... because the other problem right now is that we don't have, like, an actual table close to the couch. So, I can't have tea on the couch easily. Right now, unless I'm directly sipping it. Like, I can't put it down anywhere. That's actually a thing that's on my throne, wink, wink, wonk. They're not expensive, and I'll get one eventually. It's just, the pooper is more important right now. Eventually. Eventually, I will get one. Just like, eventually... no! More tea that I can't drink on the couch. One time I was like... lately, it was before I decided I changed my mind and watched Oshinoko. I was like, I'm gonna read more of Honzuki. But I think Joy was watching something or playing 14 and I wanted it to be more quiet. So I was gonna do it on the couch. And we haven't actually, gotten rid of all the boxes. Like, the storage boxes of my stuff. And so I actually picked up one of those and, like, pulled it over to the couch. And I was like, I'm just gonna use this for today. And then I was like, oh yeah, I could actually just watch Oshinoko. And so I did. I was like, it's probably like 2 episodes right now, right? And then I was like, why the fuck is the first episode an hour? Hello? But anyway, yeah, I changed my mind that time. But maybe not today. I finished the other day watching a video about mouth rigging, but I think I need to actually sit down and have it open while I'm doing it. I also have Cozy Chew's guide as well, so. Yeah, oh, that's the other thing I want to do. I want to make a new, what is it? Starting, like, you know, the starting soon, ending soon screen. Not that that art is bad or anything, but it's kind of old now. And I think I would be happy. I would want a new piece of art there. But also, I would have a new main outfit, huh? Alright, I have to go on the lighter side for this. This is one thing I always... I'll be honest. I always worry a lot about accidentally making a character too light-skinned. That's actually why, like, even with, like, 14 characters, I, like, consistently eyedrop their color. Unless I can tell, like, from the picture what type of lighting source they had. And, like, figure out which direction I should take the skin tone. I really don't want to get it wrong on something like that, you know? Yeah, I'm pretty happy with my new outfits that I designed. I do eventually want to, like I said, sit down and do like a full model as well as the chibi. But we'll get there. I still have to finish rigging her. She's not done. But I do still think, unless I feel comfortable with it... I mean, if I were to do a full model, I'd probably, like, almost absolutely, certainly have to run, the... What's it called? Pro upgrade to get all of the layer... to get, like, even just the amount of art meshes, right? Like, the amount of art meshes I have means that I can't really do, like, extra outfits. But the other thing is that also, like, if I feel confident enough... The palette... I don't actually have the art mesh for it. So, the base model, the base version of the chibi won't have it unless I make it with what art meshes I already have. I don't have art mesh space! Look. I'm already considering upgrading briefly to the pro version to add her cup comfy outfit as well. So we'll see. I have to get the... I want to get all the base pieces meshed or rigged first, you know? It's likely it will come back. Just not right off the bat because apparently I'm out of... I could make it without extra meshes maybe. Like, maybe. Maybe with deformers? Maybe. It could maybe still exist without an extra art mesh. But it might have to wait until the outfit upgrade. It might have to wait until the outfit upgrade. Just until I finish the base stuff, you know? Alright, this is gonna have to be duplicated onto both of these layers. So this. And then put this in here. Also in here. It's literally just, I don't have the space for it yet. I realized I did the mouthpieces wrong, so I already had to like scrimp a little bit. I think it's which show is it? Nichijou? Used a Vocaloid back in the day to do their Helvetica standard bit. Like the vocals that went with that song. Which is not necessarily AI. But oh, that's interesting that the show had an episode about AI voice acting too. See, we also know that there are some Vocaloids and stuff of like living people, but usually not all. Like, unless they're designed to be a character, so like they're basically intended to be their own identity. You know, like if they're meant to sound like Elvis, like that's usually not okay. I think we have one Japanese singer that they made a Vocaloid of, but it's never been released to the public. Because the singer is deceased. Yeah, I don't remember. I didn't realize this, but apparently Gactpoid has not gotten updates in like forever. Probably because Gact has gotten into a lot of trouble. Because with Gumi, right? Because we have Gumi, who's Megumi Nakajima. Or Megpoid is the full name. But we also, with her, came Gakpo. And then he just kind of disappeared. Apparently he's just not getting updated because Gakt is something. Something about tax fraud? I think. Wait, really? I only know of him. I've not like I was not somebody that followed his stuff. Yeah. A man, he kind of dumb. I see. I, on principle, did not like the Vocaloid because I don't really care for male vocals. That's not to say I don't have male vocal singers that I like. I'm just saying that it is harder to impress me. And that's all. I am saying that male vocalists have a tougher time impressing me in particular. But maybe I'm not their market, so that's okay. Yeah. I think maybe. I know, I think a lot of them don't use Miku. But like, I think it was Nichi... I keep wanting to say Niji Sanji. But Nichijou... I think Nijijo's was actually like one of the English ones. Not like people thought it was Luca, but I think it was one of the English ones. Sonia? At this point, like, unless their intention is to use Miku, and they probably want to steer clear of Miku just because her sound is so distinct, you know? That's not to say the other Vocaloids, at least at the time back in the day, when they were newer, Meiko and Kaito's voice banks were a bit more struggle because they were Vocaloid 1s and they didn't have a V2 upgrade. Apparently, Kaito Vocaloid, his biggest fan, is his own VA. Apparently, like, he treats him as his son and is like a massive Kaito fan. His voice provider loves Kaito so much. It's kind of cute. Let me see if I can find him. Pia Pro characters, Kaito voice provider. Naoto Fuga. Let me see it if like. Maybe? Let's see. Does he have like pictures of Kaito? Yeah, he does. Literally one of the first things you see on his Twitter. Oh my god. This is so precious. Let me show you. Like his second fucking tweet. That's here. Finished recording with my son. He literally loves Kaito so much. I am resting at a coffee shop with my sons before dubbing today. That's adorable! Anime dubbing work complete with my son. Literally, it's literally the don't ever talk to me and my son meme. But he's like, do talk to my son. Look at them, they're so cute! That's adorable. Literally, no man, woman, or child will ever love Kaito as much as Kaito's voice provider does. That's so cute! I think it's cute when they like really associate with a character that they've played. Yeah, Naoto Fuga is just like, please do talk to me and my son. It's not don't talk to me, it's please do talk to me and my son. Let me show you my son. It's adorable. I love how I opened up the Twitter though, and I'm like, let's see if he has any pictures recently. Literally the second tweet on his timeline. Literally his second most recent tweet. Me and my son. Literally the second tweet. Thank you. Oh, that's really the only. Premium Bandai too. Oh my god. Okay. Lahi? Okay. If you guys know enough about Vocaloid, which voice bank do you like the most? It could be for any reason. Aesthetic, the few songs that you know, vocal range. Which Vocaloid do you prefer if you had to hear a cover of a song in it? By one of them, which one would you prefer? Assuming it's tuned well, let's not talk about badly tuned covers. My favorite is Kagami Nadine. Mean-chan is my queen. Well, princess. I think she's... We don't want her in the queen role. She's pretty vicious as a queen. Aku no Meshitsukai. Flashbacks. And the era of Len dies in every fucking song. Damn, she's a big fan. That's like a good thing. I really thought these lyrics were like in Japanese for a while because there's like a couple parts that sound very Japanese and then it's just like, no. No, this is just generic choral noises. Sorry, I'm making the line art a little thicker. That's cute. Are there? Okay, maybe I just don't know because it's not my fandom. But like, are there any like actors or actresses like that within the Marvel shit? Or DC shit? I mean, there probably are a few. Hope so. Hawkeye? Oh. Dun, 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 dun. I imagine maybe the son, the slightly younger side might also, especially if they're like, you know, newer actors, like now. Just because, like, they would have maybe even seen some of the things back in the day. You know? Like, when they were younger. Henry Cavill. You're gonna have to tell me who that is. Sorry, zombie. Because I've only seen a few. Oh, Superman. Oh, I see. Because, yeah, I've only seen a few. The ones that, Haru's asked me to go with. I think the only one that I was, like... genuinely interested in a bit was the Amazing Spider-Man, the animated one. Look, I just like animation. I really struggle to be invested in live action. Spider-Verse, that was close. It was one of the Spooter movies, you know. Close enough. Close enough for not remembering very good. But yeah, I feel like, I don't know. Yeah, I mean, we all know that Western society kind of shames animation, right? So, like, I always feel like there's something wrong, or like something where I like I see a live action movie and I'm just like immediately turned off. I'm just like, I don't care. I was holding up my cup of tea, so that's why I had a little puffy cheek on. It's like, you show me animated, it's like, it's literally that Gaijin 4 coma. It's like, you see a live action movie and I'm just like, but then like, change it to animated and I'm just like, oh, you know? Could be the same goddamn thing, but animated, and I'm just like, yep, that's better. But like, you know, I feel like that's weird that I have such a strong preference against live action, you know? It's not like I choose to not be interested in it, it's just, I don't know. I look at it and go, meh. You know? And like, I couldn't tell you why. Just do. Okay, I'm trying to figure out, are those streaks? I think those are streaks. Yeah, those are streaks. Okay. My thing is just the general aesthetic, just I'm like, eh. Eh. Just the general aesthetic, I just kind of look at it like a live action, I'm like, not really my thing, I think. You know? It's just the immediate look at the aesthetic, I'm like, eh, don't care anymore. Yeah, like, Western society will try to tell me that I am acting like a child. That I have childlike interests or whatever. I'm only kind of thinking about that because I don't know if you guys saw when this happened over on Twitter, right? What is it? There is that one cosplayer, right? Maybe you guys saw it. There's this one cosplayer who did, like, two characters from One Punch Man. And one of them is... the lady's just really tall, okay? She's just a really tall lady. But then... I think it's even her girlfriend. Is really small, right? And some people were like... but they were dressed in bunny suits. And I'm sure you can kind of guess where I'm going. Yeah. Even recently, she's like, she tweeted about how, like, I got death threats for this. And it's like literally happening. It literally happened a second time all in that thing. It literally, it keeps happening. And like, there's somebody being like, she has child, she still has plushies. And stuff like, in pink, cute stuff. She's still, like, they're still children. Like, bro, what? Sorry that, like, you really seem to commit to the whole, like, I can only do death and taxes now. The minute I turn old, I must not have fun. Oh, I miss the... I missed the awful gif. I gotta do that again. Nah, Joey linked it to me recently because, yeah, she retweeted it about it. And it's just like... It's literally... Internet cannot be normal about short people. Lolas! Okay, I actually say this, like, there's this one image. I'm gonna share it. Where is it? Lolafel aren't children, you just infantilize short people. Lolas are literally canonically like adults. Like, have you ever seen Gege Ruju and how horny he is? He's very horny. That's all I really gotta say. He's very horny. He's extremely horny. And his assistant is too, who's also a Lolafel. Just in case you wanted to know. I think it was in one of the seasonal events that we got to see his assistant. It's literally, the internet can't be normal about short people. To be fair though, yeah, Gege Ruju does deserve the bonk. He is... Yeah, pretty horny. Like, I guess good on him. Like, he's an adult, just... Bruh. Bruh. My good sir. Stop. Oh, maybe not my good sir. He's, like I said, maybe not good. But yeah, it literally is. All of all aren't children. You just infantilize short people. And like, you have to like fight these people to like convince them. And they never really, like, to like make them make it clear. Like, no, I'm not a child. This character's not a child. They're just short. What is your problem? Have you... And they always lowball your age, like, their character's age by, like, so much. And you're like... They're like 10. Like, bro, a 10-year-old, have you ever seen that as boobs? And it's always women characters, too. And women, it's never guys. Well, not always, but yeah. Oh my god, right? Exactly. That's why I'm like, that's what I was fine talking about. It's just like, that was kind of like the thing that I was talking about, right? Where it's just like, I feel like, I don't want to like talk about how like, I literally just immediately disinterested in a film if it's live action, you know? But also Lion King, I think in, like, honestly, Lion King is probably, like, a really sad-looking, live action. Because the original animation was so colorful. And, like, if you're trying to go for a more realism look, you literally can't... Like... Like, what is there to be ashamed about, like... Enjoying an aesthetic, like, enjoying, like, human art. There's nothing shameful about animation. Animation is an art form. Why? I am very tired of things in the Western, entertainment sphere. Yeah. It's almost kind of one of those reasons why it's like, yeah, it's a good thing that like most Japanese companies literally go,
"Who are you?"
When like Western fans be like, "Oh, this is so terrible. This is so horrible." And like, they'll be like, "Who are you?"
We can just not release it to Crunchyroll.
A place for dark and edgy, or even like darker storylines. But like, yeah. Hi, Kula. I'm rambling about my taste being seen as childish in the Western sphere, because I pretty much immediately just cease being interested the minute I see live action. But the minute you put an animated piece in front of me, I'm like, oh, yes. Yeah, like, children are far more perceptive than people give them credit for. It's not even cool, it's not even about weeb, like, it doesn't matter where it came from. The thing is that Western animation is just, like, not a thing anymore. That's the problem, that's the only reason I retreat to Japan. You know, like, Disney has some pretty good, Disney and Pixar have some really good, like, 3D animation, and I'm not even, like, I don't diss on 3D animation either. Like, 3D animation can be really nice. And I'm okay with it, in theory, being the now standard for animated films in the West. I just wish we also had a bit of the other kind, you know? 2D style as well. But you can also see that, like, a lot of the animators for these 3D animated films are slowly starting to try to emulate more of 2D animation. I think that's good, because 2D animation has so many positives to it. But so does 3D animation, like, you know? I think trying to blend the best of both as best you can is good. But yeah, like, animation in the West has, like, really slim pickings, and it's just sad because, like, you show me the same film in both versions, and I will immediately gravitate towards the animated version. But I'm made to feel, at least in the West anyway, that that's childish. And I know, don't, like, worry about what people judge you for or whatever, but there's still a bit of me, right, that's like, well, I guess I can never talk about this with random persons. You know? Guess I can never discuss this out in public. You know? And it becomes harder for me to also make friends. Because, you know, how can I talk about my interests with random people? And to me, that's how I make friends. Like, if you don't share my interests, I probably, like, won't really have any reason to become friends with you. No offense. This is no offense to anybody, I'm just stating, like, that's how I make friends. That's always how I've made friends, right? I never said that. It's one of those things, though, that, like... Yeah, I don't know. Like, yeah. I want friends, but I want friends that I can talk about my interests with. And the thing is that, you know, a random person that I make friends with, right? Oh, like... If I were to randomly pick a American, right? Randomly pick an American, right? The probability that they think my interests are childish is relatively high, and that makes me sad. Just a little sad. Pretty cute. It's a Maho Shoujo for literally children. But like, it's a very fun magical girl series that airs every Sunday. Very fun. Very cute. It has been running for 20 years. This year is its 20th anniversary. It's like... Power Rangers, but girls. And animated. That's really like the quickest way to explain it, huh? You probably saw Power Rangers when you were younger. At least in passing. Meh. Oh yeah, there's Sailor Moon, right. I don't know why I forgot about Sailor Moon and Cardcaptor Sakura. Damn, I have potato brain. I think Precure is probably closer to Sentai and Power Rangers than Sailor Moon, though. As far as, like, structure, you know? I think it's a little bit more leaning towards that. Like, Sailor Moon is a long-running, like, singular story, yeah? Like, for literal years. But, like, Precure is more like... I mean, they do have a singular story arc, but it's more like each year they reboot and start over. There's a little bit of a different structure to it, you know? That's why I think comparing it, at least structurally, to Power Rangers might be better. Because Power Rangers, even in the States, still reboots every year, right? Question mark? Oh wait, are they dead? Did they reboot every few years? Ah. Yeah. That's gonna go probably terribly. That is probably gonna go horrifically wrong. Because almost every Western attempt to make their own thing based on Japanese media tends to go really bad. Well, not always. The Mario movie came out okay. What other attempts? Like, I heard the Death Note movies, the Death Note thing, the Netflix adaption was bad. What other attempts? Oh no, you're fine, Kula. What other attempts is the Cowboy Bebop? Didn't people not like that? Okay, that answers that question. The answer is yes, people did not like that. Got it. Did I ever tell you guys that one time we watched Cowboy Bebop in what is it? One of my college classes? I think we only watched like the first episode or two. Nope, in a class. What was that class called again? Japanese pop culture and something or other. So I mean, yeah. I did a presentation about Vocaloid for one of my things, and some normie asshole decided to be really weird about it. Oh well. The teacher was very nice. That was one of the teachers that wrote a recommendation letter for me to study abroad. He was very nice. Ooh, I'm getting a weird bump from my... I'm getting, like, from the edge of my, glove. It's rubbing against my thumb really weird. I'm gonna finish this. And then I will probably... I mean, it's already almost 11, but I'm definitely gonna... I'm only gonna end just because I'm... The glove is sitting weird on my thumb. Yes. But it's just rubbing against my skin funny. It's just rubbing against my skin funny, so... Yeah. Nothing too serious, just... Yeah. It definitely is gonna start to bother me eventually. But so does everything one day, you know? A lot of things will eventually bother you, either on accident or on purpose. Nah. Maybe they just come in at the wrong time, you know? Yeah, literally normies re... Oh yeah! Did you guys ever play, there's this live, not live, light, no, VN, visual novel sort of thing called Hate Plus. I think the other one was Hate, an analog, a hate story or something, and then Hate Plus. I played both of those in one of the other classes, so it was more general, like Chinese, Korean, Japanese. One of the students actually brought it up. I was like, oh, I know that! I actually, I have the legacy version of the cake achievement. I actually sent a picture of the cake eating with Kanye. Yep. I got it the old way, before you could just insert a code for it. Yeah, it was relatively meta. But it was kind of meant to be like... It talks a lot about specific era of Korean history. Which is why the student, the one kid brought it up. Because he did like a presentation on that era of Korean history for that class. I don't think the teacher, like, thought it was bad or anything. So, like, it wasn't received poorly, at least from the teacher, you know? It wasn't, like, a major part of his thing, though. Like, it was just one of those, like, by the way, there's this cool thing that if you want to see more of a, like, modern take on it a bit, like, this. Like, it wasn't, like, his main, you know, like, source or anything. But I remember, it was one of those presentation days, so I was kind of, like, super sleepy. So, like... I was just, like, barely paying attention to the presentations. But, like, I was like, wait a minute, I know that! And, like, kind of woke back. No. Thank you. But it really was when I was like, wait a minute. Like, I was like half listening, and then I'm like, wait a minute, I know that. I think he was kind of happy that I was, that he wasn't the only one that knew about it, though. I mean, of course, like, it's a pretty niche game, right? So. Of course, like, someone would be happy to, like, realize that, oh, I'm not the only one that knows about this niche game. Nah. Nana, hi! Wait, something on my face? What the heck could it be? My face? It's my face. It's you! How are you, though? Oh, welcome back, EA! Da-da-da. Okay. I need to add the white parts. Oh, it was a good walk, I'm glad. I forgot that you went to take a walk. I was like, I kind of forgot until you mentioned it again. Because potato brain. Two miles is no joke, definitely. Well, I hope it was... Was it a good 2 miles? I hope so. Okay. Whoa, you still have to walk back to your house. Oh my goodness. You're like watching on the go? My, what is it? My compression glove is rubbing my thumb a bit weird, so we're actually gonna be ending in a little bit. I'm just gonna save these out. Oh wait, let me double check. Are these? No, those are not. I almost didn't give it the correct colors for the line art. Make the house pick you up. Right, let me use my button. For CSP actions. I have a CSP action that, that's on my, what is it called? Stream Deck? That just does my hotkey for save as PNG. So that I don't have to click it every time. I don't have to remember what the button is either. It's a lovely... I love this folder, honestly. Alrighty. There we go. Okay. Are they evolved into converting their tiny cars into campers? Oh my gosh. Well, we finished the Oshinoko thing that if I like... Depending on which company I like, I will go with them and order some stickers. Because I think this will definitely sell. And I definitely want to do... I'll definitely... Maybe tomorrow? Oh, the other thing I need to do is a thumbnail. Well... It's getting late. I'm gonna have to do it tomorrow. And again, my thumb... Like, it's just sitting weird. So, I'm gonna give me a break. And I will do it tomorrow. I have to do a thumbnail for P8S, so... I'm very happy with Oshino. She came out cute! Fuck! I'm glad I drew her. I think she's adorable. I would die for her. She's so cute. God. Alright, and that's my commission done for today. No, no. I just feel bad that I got, like, really grumpy. Alright, let's see here. Oh. Let's see. Let's see who we can say hello to. I will definitely give my thumb a rest. Because like I said, I think it's just it was sitting weird on my finger. So. Oola! No! Yeah, I think it's just that weird. It's still bugging me. So, no more drawing. But I will maybe think of poses for the twins. for Ruby and Aqua. So that I can have those two to go with her. Alright, I think I know who we're gonna say hello to, but let me just check that they're not ending soon. I think so. I think we're good. Okay. Yeah, please take it easy, everybody. Hi, great. We're gonna go say hi to Indecisive Fox. They're playing Call to the Lamb. I think there was an update recently. Alright, I'm gonna rest my hands. I will be back tomorrow. Here's our raid message. I'll be back tomorrow with Final Fantasy XIV, the critically acclaimed MMORPG, and yada yada yada. But we'll be doing probably Mog Tome Collection stuff, so it'll be pretty chill, pretty lax, relaxing, and probably kind of chatty if I... Well, assuming I'm not feeling not chatty tomorrow. I think I picked up eventually, but my thumb is disagreeing with that. But yeah, you guys enjoy your evening, and see you guys next time! Oh, right! And if you guys don't already... Please make sure to check out my YouTube for tomorrow. There'll be an animation. And I gotta go before that timer runs out. So please check YouTube for animation tomorrow morning. Okay, oyasumimi. Bye-bye. Bye-bye.